Hello and welcome. I have been an Anki user for 10 years, longer than that. And I have been using SuperMemo for about a month. As you can see here, 30 days. And I put quite a few hours in, actually. So if I go to the sleep chart, as you can see, the time. 4 hours, 3 hours, 4, 3 hours, 5 hours, and August, the last day in August, I did 6 hours of incremental reading. So I did a pretty strong commitment. And you can see the difference here is that first I use a very long sessions because I was recording my screen, and later on here is when I'm using just whenever I want to. So you can see I'm using sessions across the day. So about the stats, is how are my stats? So for now I have always total time. So I have been doing repetitions for less than 2 hours. This is ridiculous. If I was being using Anki, that's almost a day. Or, yeah, usually I'm doing 1 hour or something a day in Anki. So, and that's a month. That's because in Anki, usually, almost all I do is reviewing. I add little cards, and there are some days that I add no card at all, or even weeks, I add no card, no single card. And that's because out of so that many hours, I only spend a fraction of this time doing repetitions because I am starting fresh, a fresh collection. So I have been reading and chunking down the articles. So I guess in the future, this will be changing as well as the speed, which is still huge. What else? The average for getting index is close to the one I said, which is in the 7%, and the retention rate now it's almost 95%. This morning before doing the session was above 95%. That's because if you pay attention here, the forgetting index for today is pretty bad. 31%, almost a third. I lapsed almost a third of my repetition, almost a third of my outstanding items. Yeah, no, I said it right. Which is it's a very bad performance. If I go to the settings here, cooldown. So here's one issue is that I have been using my laptop and on my desktop. So I have been using the backups. And I don't know why this day doesn't have the time. It just says for 4 minutes. And if I go here, sleep chart, the 7th, it's more than 3 hours. That's because I know this data is saved in a different file. So I don't know why it's not registering here the time. So the forgetting, not this one. Whoops, used, outstanding. Yeah, as you can see, I have been importing so many stuff. Memorized, efficiency, what's the forgetting index? Recall. Yeah, that's from today, which it's not even in the 70%. Stability. And so on. So my thoughts are actually good. I know the basics now, and I get the flow. So I get the big picture, the semantic connections that I was very hard to do in Anki, because you have to do this actually outside of of Anki. I am so far enjoying SuperMemo. And one of the issues that I have now is that I have imported so many things, so many articles, that I have just one folder with so many stuff. So I know that the knowledge tree is just optional, as Wozniak says, but I would like a more hierarchy done like this. I don't like this. It's huge. I know that the preference, the priority is the knowledge in my head, not in my collection. But at the end of the day, that will become very cumbersome to look and to search for. And one other thing that I don't do, it's setting as an article as done. See, what I do is I dismiss it. Okay, and what else? Whoops, toolkit. Who can go there? Yeah, I have so many decks already, lexicon, images, templates. Yeah, about my Anki stuff, I still have to do the coding for everything. I have carried some tests. So you can see those topics are separated from the XML. I haven't done anything, absolutely anything manual. This is all automated. So I generated different cards from one node, being a topic here. And same for Hangul. And not only that, is that I apply different, as you can see, I'm applying different templates. Because when you are importing from a XML file, you can only apply one template for all of them. And I don't want that. So what I do actually is I apply one template and then I reapply templates based on the a given criteria. So I do this in bulk, so it's really easy. I go search and I go to some tag I just did for myself. And that's it. A matter of seconds. And the other thing that I want to comment on is that outside of the software, SuperMemo, and the wiki, and so on, all the official stuff is the community. The community, it's not huge, I know. There's a lot fewer people than in Anki, but I want to underline the quality of the active users of the community. It's way beyond my expectation. Not only that they are very versed in not the software, but in the memory and how to learn and learning how to learn and this kind of thing, on sharing the knowledge and this smart community engagement, is that they are building their own tools for SuperMemo, which is not that easy as in Anki because it's open source and you can get add-ons done very easily. And in SuperMemo, I think I have briefly tried SuperMemo Assistant. It's very hacky. You load the add-on or plugin, then the application is like everything is in memory or something like that. It's not the best approach, but since it's proprietary, it's the only way to do it. And the community even run podcasts, or some of the most active users have blogs, and good, very high quality blogs, and even podcasts. And even in the Discord, they run a community, I don't know how to call it, a community-driven debates in one or twice a month. And it's pretty interesting. That's how it's called a golden nugget. Absolutely brilliant, and this adds so much value to the SuperMemo. So the thing is that usually what I thought at the beginning, 1 month ago, is that, okay, I will do this myself, absolutely alone, as how I learned Anki back in the day, in 2009, absolutely alone. And this hasn't been the case. I had a quick start with the help of Rush, Superman community user. And not only that, I have been able to ask questions. Not all, I didn't have a reply of everything, but most of what they have been asking, I got an answer. And yeah, this make a huge difference, because if I should be doing this by myself, I will be not only going slower, but only as well, all the motivation will be different. It makes a huge difference now. What I'll be doing is I will switch in the sense that I am using SuperMemo as my main application. This doesn't mean I will give up Anki, using Anki. I will keep using it, because what I do with one particular deck is that I generate the content, and I it's like Anki that you can update the deck. So I do this actually myself with another source outside of Anki. So I regenerate the content on the decks, and that's something I think that's something I cannot do in SuperMemo. Even though I know it's absolutely a bad idea, because I'm seeing cards for the first time in SRS. So it's first you understand, then you memorize. And I'm seeing this for the first time in SRS. So I would memorize at the same time that I'm planning, which is not a good idea. But since I am already in the long run, I made more than 1 million reviews. I just have left just a tiny bit. I don't know the percentage, but I think I have done more than 80% of the database. So I will just end what's left, and I will be keeping Anki with that. And also, I don't want to mess around with SuperMemo. I want to keep it clean. Even though I will try to import about 80,000 cards. That's everything I could import. So I will start for the more little things. I'm very mature, so I don't care, for instance, the Kana. I don't care if I reboot this from scratch, because I have very few cards. In this case, items. So in the next 30 years, what can I waste? 10 minutes, 20 minutes, half an hour? I don't care. But if I want to import 50,000 items, then I do care to get the shuffling data. And that's everything I want to cover. I don't want to make this video any longer. So the key point is that I am absolutely hooked. I think I will be using SuperMemo for life. I am still in the learning curve. There are some things that I have still to learn and to do for the first time. But that needs time. So it has been really, really pleasant to do so, even though at some points at the beginning I lost the patience. But actually it's not that a big deal. So I guess just one random person, the average citizen, can learn SuperMemo with at least community driven approach. So it's not just using the official wikis, which are kind of intimidating at first. I think most of the users can cope with this learning curve. So I think in the long run we can make this SRS mainstream, or sort of mainstream. That will be all. Feel free to comment what's on your mind, or reach me in Discord. See ya.